You are watching Runs on eExtra. I am Segun Odegbami. As a kid on the streets of Jos, where there were very, very few vehicles, Jos was a very small town. We didn't have any television, we had no radio, we had very few cars in the city, and so the streets were empty. And to engage you as a young boy, you had to go into one sport or the other. And the simplest and the best of them was football. And of course, in those days, we had so many great young men who came out of Jos to play for Nigeria, and their names were all over the airwaves, and we wanted to be like them. So naturally, as a young boy, I gravitated towards football. That's how it came about. Sport and music go together, hand in hand. First, they both belong to the entertainment genre. And secondly, let me give you a good example. A few days ago, we watched the finals of the Confederation Cup between two countries whose football philosophy is coined in the musical language. The Spanish play tiki-taka. The Brazilians play samba. Both are dance moves. You see, why do you relate dance with football? Because dance is an integral part of football. The best football players are those who play football to a certain rhythm. It is about movement. You understand? So that's why the Brazilians would describe their own as samba, because it's about movement. In those days, I don't know if you know about him, Teslim Balogun, when he was teaching young boys how to dribble, he would sing a Yoruba song as you would be making your moves. Babi ma magbabe, babe magbabi. And as you are singing it, you are making the moves. So movement is an integral part of football. Movement is dance. So the two actually go together hand in hand. Maybe that's why my daughter is a dancer, she's a singer, she's an entertainer extraordinaire. And me too, I like to dance. I can't sing, but I can surely move. So generally, I just find that all those of us who are in sport naturally gravitate towards music, party, dance, you know, entertainment. So they go together hand in hand. Nigerian sport is like a microcosm of Nigeria itself. It is a reflection of the country itself. It is not immune from all the influences and all the disease and all the, you know, everything that afflicts Nigeria. Of course, naturally afflicts sport. But, you know, sport as in entertainment have a way of somehow, you know, emerging even beyond the chaos, beyond the confusion, to show our potentials as a country. Nothing holds us down. What Nollywood is doing, what the musicians are doing, what the footballers are doing, are completely a reflection of our potentials as a country. You know, we are some of the most endowed people in the world. We have everything, our country has everything. We have the largest, in fact, I hear 26 out of the 28 minerals in the world, valuable minerals in the world, abound here. We have people who have the intellectual capacity, not to talk of the artists who just flood the environment. So we have everything here. And why we are not achieving it, I think it is because as a people, we have not harnessed it. When our government, when our leaders actually capture the essence of our potentiality and start to exploit them positively and start to develop them and enrich them with knowledge, wisdom, equipment and all of that, and good governance and morals, where our values will be enhanced. We don't now think of just money, 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 and it doesn't matter how you make it, but we think of achievement, 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 and money will come as a result. Then Nigeria will become one of the greatest nations on earth. I am looking forward to that day. It may not even be in my lifetime, but I am making my own contributions to ensure that that foundation is laid. That platform is set. I'm doing it by example. I'm doing it by establishing institutions that can develop bits and pieces and become models for the rest of the country. So the business of sport is virgin in Nigeria. We haven't even scratched the surface. It is one of the fastest growing industries in the world. It is part of entertainment, it is part of tourism. And I'm just praying that our young ones who are coming up will see the opportunities that exist and go in there like you guys and tap into it and promote it and benefit from it and become very rich, very powerful, very famous people. I'm sure there are so many Nigerians that we all know whose lives, you know, we can emulate, who have led exemplary lives with dignity and integrity. Those are the ones that you should look up to. Once you look up to them, they provide you with that umbrella, then the future is going to be great.